Hello everyone, welcome to this video on computing performance indicators using data from Vapor and QGIS open source software. In the last video you saw how to compute seasonal maps of relevant variables, which will be used in this video to further compute different performance indicators. So the objective of this lecture session is to show you how to compute performance indicators, and we will see how to compute equity, beneficial fraction, adequacy, and relative water deficit. Please watch other videos in this module to get more information about these performance indicators. To recap on where we are doing our analysis, our study area is called Sinawane. It's located in southern Mozambique, and we are looking at crop sugarcane with a season, 12-month season from September to October the following year. And we are working with Vapor Data, which is an open access database based on remote sensing data on water productivity assessment, which provides all these variables, actual vapor transpiration, reference ET and NPP at a very high resolution of 100 meters for this study area. And in the last video, we computed seasonal maps for all these variables. The data for exercise you can find in this particular GitHub repository. You download this repository and you will see a folder called data, where all this Vapor data are already downloaded and clipped to the study area. So let us start computing performance indicator one by one. Let us start with the equity. So what is equity? Equity is defined as the coefficient of variation of seasonal actual evapotranspiration in the area of interest. It measures the evenness of water supply in an irrigation scheme. In our case, it is Sinawane, and only for the sugarcane cropping area. And this is how to interpret this map, or how to interpret this value. Sorry, it's not a map in this case. It is going to be one value for the entire sugarcane area. So this is how you usually interpret the value for its equity or uniformity for this study area. Now let's open QGIS. As mentioned in the other video, please open QGIS with GRASS so that we can use the GRASS modules as well. Once the QGIS is open, I will open the project which was saved in the last video, which is called seasonal. So I will open that project where all my seasonal maps are open there. I'll zoom to the Sinawane area. Okay, as you saw, equity is coefficient of variation of seasonal evapotranspiration. So let's switch off all of the seasonal maps. So this is seasonal evapotranspiration. So let us see how to compute coefficient of variation of this map. For this purpose, I will use a module called r.univar. So I'll go to processing toolbox and I'll search for r.univar, open r.univar. And r.univar calculates univariate statistics. You can see a short explanation of this module from the non-null cells of a raster map. So here I will add the seasonal AETI as actual evapotranspiration as my input map. And advantage of r.univar is that it can also calculate different percentiles. So I will also add a 99 percentile here, which we need for another indicator, and for the field separator I will select as comma, I will click on calculate extended statistics because percentile is part of extended statistics, and I will save the output to a text file which I'll say ETA stats, and I will run it. So the auto-tune mode is finished. I'll go to the folder OCW outputs, and here is my ET underscore stats. I can open it with Excel sheet. So I will open an empty Excel and I'll drag this file. So as it's a comma separated file, you can always go to data, select that column, first column, go to data, text to columns, delimited, select comma as delimited, and then you can see that all these values are in separate columns now. So you can see that a different or different statistics are already computed based on that seasonal actual evapotranspiration map. In which what we need is coefficient of variance, coefficient of variation, which is 13.9, which is almost 14 in this case. And you can also see that the percentile, 99 percentile, is also computed, which is 1648 millimeter per second. We will use this for another indicator in the coming slides. So this is the answer. 14 is a coefficient of variation. As you saw, by rule of thumb, the 10 to 25% is fair, so the system performed fair in terms of equity. Now let's move to the next indicator, which is beneficial fraction. Beneficial fraction is calculated, it's a simple calculation, it's a seasonal transpiration divided by seasonal actual evapotranspiration. Now let's go to QGIS. Let's compute beneficial fraction. So for that I will take a raster calculator, and I will double click on seasonal TA divided by seasonal ADI. That should give us beneficial fraction for the year 2018-19 crop season. So here I will type and give a name, beneficial BF underscore 2018-19. Calculation is complete. The layer is below there also. You can see that the beneficial fraction vary from 0.4 to 0.8 only. You can of course change the symbology to see it in a different perspective. So this is a beneficial fraction map for you. You can also do a simple raster statistics. So you can type, go to Processing Toolbox, type raster statistics. So you can see that there's a raster layer statistics here. You can just select PF 2018-19 and just run it. So it will display some basic univariate statistics here, like minimum is 0.4, maximum is 0.87, a mean value of 0.8 beneficial fraction. So all over the scheme, the mean and average of 0.8 is the beneficial fraction. Adequacy. So adequacy is calculated using a simple formula, which is seasonal actual evapotranspiration divided by seasonal potential evapotranspiration. So, but we haven't calculated seasonal potential evapotranspiration yet. So seasonal potential evapotranspiration can be calculated using the formula average Kc multiplied by seasonal RAT, which we already have. And average Kc from the literature or from the model under the optimum conditions is calculated as 1.045. So we'll use this value as average Kc, and we'll calculate EDP, and then we will move ahead to calculate adequacy. So I'll go back to QGIS again. At first, I will calculate potential evapotranspiration. So I'll go to RASA calculator. Let me just cross check the Kc value, it's 1.045. So here I can type 1.045 multiplied by the reference CT. So that is your potential evapotranspiration. Here I will save it as PPT. Save. And I'll get my PET value, sorry, PET map. Now I'll use this potential evapotranspiration and seasonal actual evapotranspiration to calculate adequacy. So I'll go back to RASTA calculator. So adequacy, the formula is seasonal ATI divided by potential evapotranspiration. The output layer, I will say adequacy 2018-90. Okay, and you can see that adequacy is computed. Again, you can use the RAST layer statistics to find basic statistics of this part. Now let's move to the next indicator, which is called relative water deficit. Relative water deficit is computed as 1 minus seasonal actual evapotranspiration divided by maximum ET. ETX or maximum ET is calculated, in this case let us calculate it as 99% of the actual evapotranspiration. We have already computed the 99% in the first step in the R2T UR output. So you can see that the 99% is 1648.6. So I will copy that value. Now let's go to QGIS and compute RWT. So I'll go to raster calculator again. Let's say 1 minus, I will open a bracket, seasonal actual evapotranspiration divided by 99% of seasonal evapotranspiration, close the bracket, and that is your RWD. So I'll give an output mean here. RWD. Let's say okay. So this is your RWD map, and again you can use RAST layer statistics to compute a basic univariate statistics of this layer, or you can also use R.UniVar univar to compute statistics. That's end of this lecture to compute performance indicators. Thank you.